Hey guys, look at my hair today. It's straight. I don't know what the deal is with my hair. Every day it's different. Okay, I did not come to talk about my hair today. I came because I was just on my walk. I just got home from my morning walk and I get all these strikes of inspiration about things that I want to share with you when I'm on my walks. So today I was thinking, I've had a lot of people contact me and tell me, and I'm so grateful for this, that my exercises on my YouTube channel have really helped them. They used to be unable to go to workout classes and that kind of thing because their prolapse would get worse, they'd feel an increase in pressure, they'd have bladder leakage, that kind of thing. But then when they do my videos here on YouTube, they're not having those issues and they can do them. So I'm grateful to hear that every time, beyond grateful, and I'm so thankful. However, I want to share with you that really what I do in my videos, it's not rocket science, and you can really apply the concepts that I use in my workouts to any workout, almost any workout, and have a safer experience that is safe for your core, safe for your pelvic floor. I think sometimes we chalk it up as normal and just a normal part of aging or just a normal part of being a woman to, you know, leak when you're in a workout class or feel that your prolapse is getting worse and that pressure downward. But again, don't just take that as, well, it's just a normal part of aging. Take it as this is your body trying to communicate to you that there is something that is wrong, something that needs to be tweaked and changed. And luckily, most of the time you can tweak and change it using these simple tricks. You may look a little different. If you're in a group fitness class setting, you might need to do things a little bit differently than other people because your teacher may not be aware of these issues. Your teacher may not have experienced these issues herself, or she or he may just not have been educated on these issues. So you may need to advocate for yourself and do things a little differently, and I'll share with you now how. So some of the ways that my workouts are a little different than some other workouts in this world are, again, just small changes. For one thing, my workouts are generally pretty low impact. So you may need to modify your classes down so that if there's some jumping around that tends to make you have leaks, then don't just stand there, but change it up. Do something that's a lower impact. Be creative, use your imagination. So again, my workouts are lower impact. You may need to lower your impact as well. If you're in a group class, for example, that's just not working for you, listen, don't just push through. Listen to your body, modify, make adjustments, okay? So that's the first one. The second thing that I always talk about is posture and alignment. So if your teacher is maybe not so focused on good posture during, say, like a body pump type class, I don't know if that's a trademarked word, I don't know, but I don't know the right word for it, but like a class where you're using weights and you're lifting weights and you're doing things maybe kind of quickly, lifting weights and then doing other moves, whatever it may be. If you're going through the moves pretty quickly and there's not a strong emphasis on posture, then you need to slow down yourself. Take it slower. Your teacher won't care if you're doing half-time reps. If you're going slower so that you can be sure that you're maintaining good alignment, so that your, you know, ribs are, they're in, they're not thrusted forward as you're doing these moves. You're not thrusting your body around as you're doing weights. It's so easy to have that happen, like so easy. But in order to really protect your abdominal wall, to protect your back, to have a strong and engaged core, which you really need during those isolated periods of, okay, I'm going for my core strengthening right now. When you're really tuned in to that move, you need to be turned on in your core extra. You need to be extra activated and you need to be extra hyper-focused on maintaining good posture. Because again, if you don't, you can throw your back out, you can overstretch your abdominal wall. If you're flexing in a weird way or your posture is in a funny way that's putting downward pressure on your pelvic floor, that's not good either. So in order to really maintain your optimal position of your spine for spine health and also for pelvic floor health and also the optimal position for your core muscles to be able to really be able to fire and support you, you have to be in good alignment. So if that requires you to slow down, even my videos might go way too fast for some people. Slow down, make it your own. Don't be afraid to slow down. So another thing that my videos focus less on is I don't do a lot of sit-ups or, well, I don't think I've ever done a sit-up in any of my videos. I may be wrong, but I don't do sit-ups so much. And I don't do a lot of crunches, abdominal crunches on my back. Now, the reason is both of those moves, sit-ups and crunches, can be problematic for people with diastasis recti, which is the weakness in the anterior abdominal wall, and also for people with prolapse. I won't get into that now, but they can be problematic. So I don't tend to focus on those moves. But other classes do focus a lot on abdominal crunches and sit-ups. A lot of classes also focus a lot on planks. Planks are generally okay, and I do planks in some of my videos, absolutely. But I tend to do them with a lot of awareness and focus on really activating the pelvic floor and core. And if you have a very severe diastasis recti or a more severe prolapse, it may be difficult to get into the position properly. And it may also be difficult for you to keep your core engaged since you are in a position where gravity is pulling your anterior abdominal wall down because of the position you're in. Same thing with hands and knees. So if you're in those positions and you feel like you can't maintain that slight lift or engagement of your core, if you can't feel the core activation in a plank, then you need to take a rest, okay? Take a rest in child's pose. You need to be sure that you're really tuned in. Back to the whole sit-ups and crunches idea. If you're doing crunches and sit-ups in a class and the instructor is really kind of going for it and you're feeling like you can't keep your pelvic floor lifted and your abdominals pulled in, and maybe you can't keep up with the breathing, you're supposed to exhale as you crunch. If you're not able to keep up with that, or if you just feel like it's not right for your body, then stop. And instead of crunches, you can pretty much never go wrong with bridges. I think bridges are about the best move ever, where you're lying on your back, knees are bent, feet on the floor, and you're just lifting your hips up and down off the floor. It's a great exercise for strengthening the whole backside of your body. Our glutes in this day and age, our butt muscles, are very, very weak and underutilized because people aren't walking and moving and lifting and doing all the great things that we, you know, are supposed to do as a people. We're not doing that so much anymore. So, hey, use that time, skip the crunches and do bridges instead. I think the last thing that I want to talk about is to really focus on exhaling with exertion. And honestly, this was probably the most beneficial thing I learned in high school. It's so funny that I learned it all the way back in high school. I think my two most important things that I learned in high school were keyboarding class, because obviously in, you know, the computer age now, and this is back in the, you know, early the 90s, I will just say, in the 90s, keyboarding class was so key because obviously today I use my keyboard all day long. So keyboarding was huge. And the other thing that was so big for me in high school, way more important than calculus, way more important than all those other things I learned, was in my weightlifting class, which was awesome. We learned to exhale with exertion. We learned to exhale as we did the lift. So exhale as we curl the weight or as we push the weight or as we, whatever we're doing, you exhale. So I've carried with that with me through now. I've learned that there actually is a major benefit to exhaling with exertion when it comes to pelvic floor health. I've talked about this a lot before, so I'll just be brief, but when you exhale, you're not only naturally activating the core muscles, but you're also lifting the breathing diaphragm. It naturally rises when you exhale. That allows your pelvic floor to lift as well. They work together. So it prevents excessive downward pressure on your pelvic floor and pelvic organs when you exhale. I place a strong emphasis in breathing in my YouTube videos, and that might be why you feel that they're better for you than certain other classes where maybe there's not as much talk about the breathing. So even if you just have to remember in your own mind, you can take this with you to your exercise classes. You can be the weirdo who's breathing and with some gusto, if you will. I think it's important to breathe and, you know, make it be heard, because sometimes if you go like that, it really helps you connect and get more of a engagement of your core, more of a lift of the pelvic floor, and it just honestly helps keep your mind on task, I think. So you don't have to breathe super loudly, but I find that it's actually quite helpful when it comes to exercise classes to go for it. Exhale with exertion when you're in a more active fitness class. Now with yoga, the breathing might be a little bit different. You might be doing Ajayi breathing. You might be doing a whole different kind of breathing. Again, won't get into that today, but I'm thinking more of general fitness classes. Exhale with exertion. Oh, that reminds me. One other move that I see all the time in fitness classes, and it just makes me crazy, are moves where maybe you're on your back and your legs are going down and up. Now, I do moves like this in some of my videos, but I really try to make clear that your low back needs to stay neutral and engaged, maybe even erring toward pressing into the floor. I don't want you rounded and hunched and rounded, curved into the floor, but you want your back down. If your low back starts arching because your legs go down and lift back up, as your legs are going down and up, that is not safe. It is not safe for your pelvic floor. It's not safe for your anterior abdominal wall. It's not safe for your back. So that kind of falls into the category of focusing on alignment, which we talked about already, but just beware of that. Long story short, not so short, but long story long, you have to advocate for yourself. I am all for exercise fitness classes. I think they're fun. I think that they're a great way to get community, interaction, or even if you're just doing a video on your own on YouTube, my videos or anybody else's videos that are out there, even if you're doing, you know, yoga, fitness, step aerobics, kickboxing, whatever it is, try to keep these little tips in mind. So we talked about proper posture and alignment, exhaling with exertion, skipping the sit-ups and crunches, or at least, you know, making sure you're doing them correctly, maybe substituting a bridge move instead of sit-ups and crunches if they're heavily emphasized. If you want to know more about proper crunches, if you just really love crunches, again, I do them in some of my videos. You just need to keep your pelvic floor and core pulled in and up, and you need to exhale as you crunch. Breathe out as you crunch. If you notice a pooching or a doming of your belly, it's not okay. If you feel an increase in pressure in your pelvic floor, it's not okay. Okay. With planks, be careful. Make sure that you can keep your core fully engaged throughout the plank. If you can't, then rest in child's pose. You may need to slow your moves down so that you can maintain that proper alignment and proper breathing. And you may need to make your moves slightly lower impact than the rest of the class. Don't feel bad about it. Just know that you need to respond to your body. Now, the way to respond is to modify, not to stop completely. I don't ever want anyone to fear movement. Movement is essential. Movement is huge. Movement will keep you strong for life. But you may need to modify in order to meet your needs at this in this season of your life. So again, I hope that really helps you make any exercise and fitness class or video or routine that you do a little bit safer for your needs. Again, there's nothing that special or unique about what I'm doing on YouTube. I'm just trying to keep my moves fairly low impact and core and pelvic floor friendly by thinking about alignment, breathing, and all that stuff. So you can do it too. Anyone can do it. I hope this helps you, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'll try to get back to you, and as always, remember, eat clean, move every day, and you will shine brighter. Bye.